Dear brothers, dear sisters, we are approaching Ramadan. And Ramadan is a month of blessings and a month of goodness and a month of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Ramadan we fast. Many of us also pay the zakah in Ramadan. And they do many acts of goodness. Today's khutbah is on a reminder that will help us achieve those goals inshaAllah. It's a reminder to learn. It's a reminder about knowledge. About knowledge in Islam. If you want to fast properly, we need to learn how to fast properly. And teach our children. Teach ourselves, remind ourselves of those rules and the benefit of fasting. Remind ourselves of zakah and the benefit of zakah and how to calculate zakah. But also knowledge in general. As you know, in Islam, knowledge has a specific place, has a special place. It is one of the sha'air of this ummah. It is one of the trademark of Islam. And the Prophet ﷺ was sent as a teacher. One of his qualifications is that he's a teacher. And he said it himself. He said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ مُعَلِّمًا. I was sent but a teacher. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described him in the Quran by telling us that it is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that sent to us from amongst ourselves a messenger, يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ, that will recite to us His signs, will recite to us the scriptures, will deliver the scriptures as is, will recite the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as is, without addition, without subtraction. When we learn, we try to learn knowledge as is, without addition, without subtraction. When we quote people, we quote them accurately, as is, without addition, without subtraction. We don't put words in their mouths, we don't twist their words. We quote knowledge accurately, we learn knowledge accurately, and we transmit knowledge accurately and precisely. Because knowledge is one of the two things that make a person human, that make us humans, as humans. As you know, a human being is someone who is a rational living being, is someone who has life and has intellect, someone who can think, someone who can learn, someone who can learn. And the more we learn, the more we approach our humanity. The less we learn, the less we renounce our humanity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says that He is the one that, وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. He is the one that brought us from the wombs of our mothers, knowing nothing. When we are born, we know nothing. We are a clean page, we are an empty page. But He gave us the tools to learn. He gave us the tools to acquire knowledge. And those tools are three. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةِ. Three sources of knowledge. And He gave us three tools in order to achieve and learn and acquire those knowledge through these three sources. And the sources of knowledge are the senses and the intellect and transmission of information. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us ears so that we can hear information when it's transmitted, and gave us eyes so we can observe things and experiment, observation and experimentation, and gave us hearts and mind and brain in order to reflect and think. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran described those that do not use these tools our ulama emphasize the usage of these tools. These are the windows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to us. These are the keys that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to us. And with those keys we can open doors. We can open doors and then go inside. And go deep and deep and deep. As deep as we wish. And those who do not use those tools, our ulama describes them as someone who's brought ignorance upon themselves. We are born knowing nothing. But if we do not use these tools, ignorance is brought upon ourselves by ourselves. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about those who do not use these tools. And He said, وَلَقَدْ زَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا. They have hearts and intellect, but they understand nothing with it. وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا. They have eyes, but they don't use their eyes to see things. وَلَهُمْ أَذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. They have ears, but they don't hear with these ears. And if we do not use these tools, because knowledge is part of our humanity, learning is part of our humanity. The more we learn, the more we educate ourselves, we approach ourselves being human. We become more human. We become a complete human. And the less we learn and the less we use these tools, we approach other kinds of creatures. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. Those who do not use their ears, do not use their eyes, do not use their hearts and their intellect, they are like cattle. بَلْ أَضَلُّ. No, they are worse than cattle. I.e., who does not learn, it's like someone who has renounced his humanity. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the angels that, I'm putting a successor on earth. They said, Oh Allah, are you going to put on the earth someone who will corrupt the earth and shed blood? Allah replied to the angels in two ways, by saying and by demonstrating. By saying, He told them, Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun. And by demonstration, by teaching Adam alayhi salam, وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. This creature that I'm putting on earth is a special creature. Is a creature that can learn. Is a creature that can acquire knowledge through education. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. And He told the angel, this creature will learn, have the capability of learning, have the capability of acquiring knowledge. And through knowledge, there is no corruption, there is no shedding of blood. Knowledge is a double-edged sword. There is beneficial knowledge and there is knowledge that is not beneficial. In the Quran, the first surah that was revealed is Iqra' bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Recite in the name of thy Lord. Alladhi khalaq. The one who created. The ni'mah of knowledge, the ni'mah of recitation, the ni'mah of qira'ah, the ni'mah of learning, the bounty and the mercy of learning is like the bounty of creation. It's like the bounty of giving us life. Ni'matul ilmi ka ni'matil khalq. And in this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about this and mentioned qira'ah many times. Mentioned knowledge many times, and mentioned khalq many times, and also mentioned four types of knowledge. And one of them is the worst knowledge that a person can learn, a knowledge that will cause a person to tughyan. Kalla innal insana layatgha. If you acquire a particular type of knowledge that will destroy humanity, that will cause corruption on earth, that will shed blood, this is the worst type of knowledge. It will cause a person to become arrogant and to become proud and to have pride above everything else, money above everything else. The priorities are messed up, completely messed up. And this will cause them to tughyan. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the ni'mah or the trust of moral responsibility, at the end, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبينا أن يحملنها وأشفقنا منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. Those are two qualities that will prevent people, prevent us from fulfilling the trust that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusted us with. What are those two qualities? إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. الظلم والجهل. Injustice, oppression, and ignorance. Those two qualities will prevent us from fulfilling our mission on earth, will prevent us from being Muslims. Religion of Islam is about life, how to live our life in a way that will benefit us in this world and in the next. And the opposite of zulm and jahl is ilm and adl, is knowledge and justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the angels, إني أعلم ما لا تعلمون وعلم آدم الأسماء كلها. And he taught Adam all the names. And he brought them in front of the angels. He said, أنبئوني بأسماء هؤلاء إن كنتم صادقين. قالوا لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا. They apologized right away. And in their apology, they mentioned that they have no knowledge of anything. Because ignorance is an apology. We have to apologize for our ignorance. The Prophet والسلام, taught us a principle that if we do something, let's try to keep doing it. If we recite the Quran, let's try to keep reciting the Quran. It's better that we do something a little continuously than to recite the Quran for 1 week and then stop for a year. It's better to recite one ayah every day than to recite the surah one day and then stop for 10 years. The Prophet والسلام, كَانَ إِذَا عَمِلَ عَمَلًا أَثْبَتَهُ. If he was to do anything, he would keep doing it. Continuity is something that our Sharia encourages. And learning is something that doesn't stop. We start learning as soon as we're born. And we end learning when we die. And knowledge will benefit us even in the hereafter. In the hereafter, two things will remain with us. Everything will disappear. Our ulama told us, marriage and knowledge. Our spouses in this world will be our spouses in the hereafter, inshallah, in paradise. And knowledge will also be with us in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran talked about a discussion and a conversation between the believers and the disbelievers. And he says, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ وَالْإِيمَانِ. Those who were given knowledge and faith and iman. They were given knowledge when? They were given knowledge in this world. And that's on the Day of Judgment. Those who were given knowledge in this world and iman in this world will say to the disbelievers, they say, لَقَدْ لَبِثْتُمْ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْبَعْثِ فَهَذَا يَوْمُ الْبَعْثِ. And this is the Day of Resurrection. And they say this to the disbelievers on the Day of Resurrection. After death, they tell the disbelievers. My dear brothers and sisters, we can talk about knowledge for weeks. And there are benefits and features of knowledge. I shall mention one and we close with this. One of the benefits of knowledge that it will take us from dalal to huda, from misguidance to guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He sent to us a messenger from amongst ourselves. يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمْ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Knowledge will transform us from being misguided to being guided. And knowledge is something that will benefit us even after our death. When a person dies, the Prophet ﷺ says, إِنْ قَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ أَيْ عَمَلُهُ لِنَفْسِهِ لَا عَمَلُ غَيْرِهِ لَهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. And one of them is ilmun yuntafa'u bihi. Maybe he learned something and taught it to others, and they benefited from it. And this benefit will continue even after he dies. أقول هذا القول وأستغفر الله استغفر. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. كلما تمتعت عين بنظر ووعت أذن بخبر، عباد الله اتقوا الله فيما أمر، وانتهوا عما نهى عنه وزجر، وأخرجوا حب الدنيا من قلوبكم، فإنه إذا استولى أثر. واعلموا أن الله عز وجل أمركم بأمر عميم بدأ فيه بنفسه، وسنى بملائكة قدسه، فقال عز من قائل عليما: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم فصل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد صلاة وسلاما دائمين متلازمين إلى يوم الدين. ورضي الله عن الخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن سائر الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، وأعلي يا مولانا كلمة الإيمان والحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه لكل خير، ومن أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين غير ذلك فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر. تولى المسلمين في هذه البلدة وسائر بلاد الإسلام بعين عنايتك وبأتم رعايتك، وأبدل عسرنا يا مولانا يسرا عاجلا غير آجل يا رب العالمين. وفرج الكرب عن المكروبين، ونفس الهم عن المهمومين، وردنا إلى دينك ردا جميلا كريما يا أكرم الأكرمين. اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوة. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى، وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي، يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.